Good afternoon, good evening, wherever you are in this beautiful world, whenever you're watching this video. Welcome to the Bitcoin Family YouTube channel. For the newcomers, my name is Didi Taihutu, and yes, I am the guy that with his family 4 years ago sold literally everything they owned, went all into Bitcoin and started traveling the world, and now making YouTube videos already for over a year, and we just surpassed 1 million views on our channel. Congratulations to the whole Bitcoin family, of course including myself, for reaching this really cool goal of 1 million views. In today's video, of course, bombing you with really cool Bitcoin charts, talking about the blockchain news I read this morning during my cup of coffee, and looking at the Bam Bam indicator, of course. Make sure you watch these Bitcoin charts very closely now, because there is something about to happen that you might not expect. Enjoy today's video, guys. Bam! By the way, do you like my cool t-shirt? Bitcoin, 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 Bitcoin in all colors. You can buy this t-shirt not in our store. This t-shirt was given to me by Bitcoin Wardrobe Store, btcwardrobe.com. Thank you for giving me this t-shirt. And of course, when you send me a free t-shirt, I will do a shout out, because that is how we help each other in this crypto community. You send me cool Bitcoin shirts, I give you a shout out. So please take a look at btcwardrobe.com for really cool Bitcoin t-shirts like this one. Bitcoin, 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 Bitcoin in really cool colors. Bam! You probably noticed that every video the last week was launched around 6 o'clock in the morning. Yes, I did this with a reason, because I wanted to give you the videos during your delicious cup of coffee in the morning. Now I have one problem with this, and this is that the news that you see at that moment in the morning is mostly the news from the day before in the afternoon that I read. So there's like 12 hours in between. Also, when it comes to the price information, there's 12 hours in between. I really don't feel well by this. You know, I want to perform. I want to have the news to you on the moment that it counts. Also, the price information. I want to have the price information to you the moment that it counts. So I decided to create the videos during the day, post them while I finish creating the videos, and then you can decide yourself if you watch them directly that day or in the morning at 6, because the content would be still the same. I hope you understand this. I discussed it with the whole family members at the Discord server, and they were all agreeing with me. Didi, just post it, because it is news that everybody needs to read at the moment. It still is news, and the price of course is fluctuating, so this changes really fast in those hours. So please post the price information the moment you finish your video, and the people that want to see the video in the morning, they will just watch it in the morning. That is how I will solve it for now, but I'm also thinking about a in-between solution, but you need to give me some time to figure out if I can do this, because that would mean that I, for example, would do a coffee with you guys together every morning. Coffee with Didi, let's call it like that. Bam, coffee with Didi. So every morning I wake up, I start reading the news, and during that I read the news, I do a live session with a coffee together with you guys. That would be around 7:30 in the morning, that I will be drinking this coffee together with you guys and just talking shortly, okay, which news items I have read, what I think a little bit about it, what I see in the price, and what I think about the price. And then later that day, I will go deeper into that news and the price movements in the video. That could be a step in between solution, but would mean I need to do a little bit more work, and I just don't have enough time at the moment. So let's see, I will figure out how to optimize everything so it's beautiful for you and also beautiful for me, so that we can create one huge Bitcoin happy family. Bam! Let's talk about Bitcoin, guys, about the charts. The first chart, this one, bam! We had a 13% drop, which is one of the biggest drops we have experienced in Bitcoin in a day in the last couple of months. And I'm saying 13%, but yeah, some say 14 or 15%, depending on which exchange you count the numbers on. You can see that we experienced these drops many more times. In March 2020, we had a 30% drop. In September 2020, we had an 11% drop. And now in January 2021, we have a 13, 14, 15% drop. So yes, we have seen these drops many times, But every time when we saw these drops, we also saw something else. We saw a rebound. So we dropped tremendously, but there was also a very V-shaped rebound, tremendously coming in of 20 to 30%. So I expected this to happen again, and what we see now is that it is happening again. So I expected this to happen again. Like I said in my video yesterday, I don't expect Bitcoin to go below 30K. And we bounced around the 30K level. Yes, there was a wick to 29K, but we bounced. And we are now acting around $31,800 again. So yes, I still expect that we can go higher from here, because I don't see all these institutional investors stopping to buy Bitcoin. They are buying the dip, and you should be buying this Bitcoin dip as well. And sometimes, guys, these dips, they appear for a reason, you know. Sometimes there are just too many longs on the exchanges, and then you suddenly see these huge dips with wicks, and they kill all the longs. Just like yesterday's dip killed, I think, around $460 million worth of longs after reaching an all-time high in the open interest around $13.1 billion. So that could also be the reason of these huge dips, to kill some longs. Because some companies would be making losses if too many people would be making profit. That's part of the whole cryptocurrency trading game. And I agree, it's not the most honest part of the cryptocurrency trading game, but it is part. Let's take a look at the BAM BAM indicator. This chart. BAM. On this chart, you can see we traded with $300 with a leverage of 10 on Bybit. If you want to trade using the BAM BAM indicator, do sign up using our referral links to the Bybit exchange, because at the moment they have a $600 deposit bonus. So you can get $600 by just depositing some funds to Bybit and start to trade on Bybit. $600 for free. Use our referral link. Dudex still has $300 deposit bonus, and Prime XBT has a 50% deposit bonus. So please use our referral links down below the video, because that is how we earn some fees that we again share with poor people all over the world. It's still windy. Hopefully the sound is okay again today. Like you can see on the chart, we did only two trades because I had a really busy day yesterday. The first trade, guys, was a short. The short was a 50% short, which created an amount of $450 out of the $300 we started with. The second trade again was a short that was late in the evening. That was again, I think, a 36% short, which created a huge amount of $612. We started with $300, we ended with $612. So in total, we had a $312 profit by just trading two times using the BAM BAM signals as an indicator. Yes, triple confirmation. Yes, breaking down the yellow stepping line, the BAM BAM indicator line, the blue line crossing the white line, and the red or the green one. And yes, we can see the shift from the grass, the green grass that you can see now around me, into the beach or the sea, or the other way around, from the beach and the sea into the green grass and the hills. Triple confirmation. That is when we take the trade. We took two trades, one in the morning, one in the evening, and created a profit of $312 by just using the BAM BAM indicator. That is why you should now sign up at ddbam.com. Just fill in the three fields at ddbam.com, and we will send you all the information about the BAM BAM indicator, the price, the cost, and the service we give you for that price. BAM! Let's get back to the Bitcoin chart. If we take a look at this Bitcoin chart, the 1 hour chart, this one, BAM! You can see what I was talking about. You had that V-shaped drop, and now we are coming up. We are still not confirming a new trend upwards, guys. We do need to break the 32,705 level, because that was the last, you know, drop. And then we fell down and we are coming up now. So what I want to see now is that we close the candle above this 32,705 level, because that is a confirmation of the reversal of the market again to the upside, and that can create another higher high, higher low, higher high, higher low. If we don't close the candle above this 32,700 level, we are not creating a higher high, but a lower high, and probably also then after that again a lower low around this $30,000 level. So that is where we are stuck now. But if you want to know the latest update on the price, make sure you join the Discord server, because there we will update the charts a couple of times during the day. Bam! There were all of the charts for today, guys. Let's now jump into the blockchain news part, the part where I talk about the news I read this morning during my cup of coffee. Bam! The first news that I read is very positive news. If it is true, we still need to verify this, because people are saying that Grayscale announced that they are going to open altcoin trust fund as well. One for Chainlink, one for BAT, like for Mana. So a couple of those altcoins was being told in the FUD or like rumor industry that Grayscale is going to open some funds for these altcoins as well, so that people also can invest in Chainlink, Mana, BAT, and some other altcoins. I don't know yet if it is true, but I will keep an eye on it because I want to keep you up to date on this. Bam! The next news I read is about Brazil. Na 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 na. Brazil. Because the biggest exchange in Brazil, I think it's called Mercado Brazil, that one raised another $38 million to increase their reach. So they are going to expand to other countries like Argentina and South America to offer their services to those people as well for when it comes to trading cryptocurrency. So Mercado Brazil is doing a great job in South America and trying to expand by raising some money, and they raised $38 million to do this expansion. At the moment they have 2.2 million users. I think they want to grow to 3 million users. And they are not a small exchange, because they did around $3.7 billion in volume. And of course, when they grow in the amount of users, the volume will grow as well. So they will become one of the bigger exchanges of South America. So thumbs up for Mercado Brazil. Yesterday, I already told something in the video about this Thai exchange, Bitkop. Because the Thai stock exchange didn't want to add Bitcoin and other cryptocurrencies. Bitkop is the biggest one in Thailand, but they were suspended, which I found really strange, because they were responsible for 90% of the volume in Bitcoin, and their account was suspended. So they needed to cease their activities in Thailand, which is really strange. But then, one day later, this is the most strange thing ever, Ubit is entering the market. So Ubit Thailand is entering the market. This is really strange, because how can Ubit Thailand be allowed to do all the stuff that Bitkop was doing? And exactly on the moment that they suspend Bitkop in Thailand, they enter Ubit. So I started to read a little bit more about it, and what appears is that Ubit Thailand is owned by the CP Group, which is one of the biggest conglomerates of Thailand, one of the biggest companies, and they started Ubit. So now I think, can I say it like this? I can't prove it, but I find it really strange. Did they, for example, pay the Thai government to suspend Bitkop so that they could now take over the market, because they have a huge influence in the Thai government, because they are one of the biggest companies, CP Group, of Thailand. These games are often played on these high-level things. So it could be that it also played out now like that in Thailand, and I find this really disappointing. Because I think that you can't just kill business of a company that built up the business in that country. And Bitkop did drive the adoption of Bitcoin in Thailand for many years. They are responsible for 90% of the volume, and they were just, bam, suspended. And now this Ubit comes in. Of course, it probably has to do with KYC. And I think on Bitkop, you don't need any KYC. You can just verify with an email address. And on Ubit, they do KYC. So it probably all has to do with this KYC. But I think we as a community have the responsibility to support those exchanges that don't require KYC and all that stuff. But who am I to discuss this? Because I love Thailand. At least I love the Thai food, the Thai massage, the Thai beaches, the Thai sea, and the Thai people. Maybe not the Thai corruption. Bam! And also, yesterday I talked about Biden. Yes, maybe I was a little bit negative. I need to walk that way, guys, because it's too dark. About Biden. And yes, maybe I said a little bit like negative dude, and maybe also a little bit negative, like he looks like he's almost dead, you know. But let's be honest, he looks like he's almost dead, and he can be a very fit person and a very good person, warm-hearted person, whatever, but you know, he doesn't look very fit, let's be very honest. But I also talked about Janet Yellen, this new Treasury Secretary, and I told you, the people of America think they can convert their mind. They didn't need to. Biden did. Can you imagine this whole discussion? She's saying, yeah, I don't know, cryptocurrency can be really bad. Biden calling her, hey, come to the office. Hey, Janet, come in, come to the office. And then she comes to the office and then Biden's like, Janet, why do you do this on your first day of your work? Please tell the people that the cryptocurrency is the future, man. We need to support the evolution of money. So why are you saying these negative things? And then Janet will be, yes, but. And then he will say, no, but. Do your job. Go outside and do an interview and tell the people you think different about cryptocurrency. And what did we see yesterday? Yeah, Biden was the boss. She went into an interview and what did she say? Cryptocurrency has the potential to improve the financial system. So yes, thank you, Biden, for correcting her, because she needs to understand that cryptocurrency is the next step in the evolution as money. Like I shared on my TRT interview, TRT World interview, check the link down below this video. You can watch the episode over there. But thank you, Biden. That was everything for today, guys. I hope you really enjoyed the video. If you did enjoy the video, give it a thumbs up, share it with your friends and family, subscribe to the channel, hit the notification bell, and please leave a comment, as I love to respond to your comments. Thanks for watching. Always remember to zoom out in Bitcoin and to zoom in at life. Try to enjoy every single minute of the day, and that is exactly what life should be about. And hopefully see you tomorrow again. Bye.